generous spirit.
As the hymn reminded us, God spreads a table before us, the table of the Eucharist. And today we have the great joy of celebrating the First Communion of one of our young children. Kaylee is going to come to the table for the first time and receive the body and blood of the Lord. As we rejoice with her, let us thank God once again for this priceless gift and pray that we may live in a way that is worthy of it. Have mercy on us, O Lord, for we have sinned against you. Show us, O Lord, your mercy and grant us your salvation. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Yes, Christ, have mercy.
Lord,
have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest,
and on earth peace to the people of good will.
Draw near to your servants, O Lord, and answer their prayers with unceasing kindness. But for those who glory in you as their creator and guide, you may restore what you have created and keep safe what you have restored. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Though you have no money, come.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
servant really means is that throughout the day, we have our eyes open, our ears open to what the people around us need, whether it's our own immediate family, who we're very familiar with, whether it's people on the street, just people who come to us asking for help. We try to see, we try to put ourselves in their shoes, to ask ourselves, what does this person really need? What are their concerns? What's on their mind? And is there anything I can do to help? And often we may not be able to help in any concrete way. We can't give money to every homeless person we meet on the streets, and we probably shouldn't do so. We don't have the energy to help every person we meet. But even if we just limit it to a smile or a few moments of listening to someone, we're already showing them that we are humble and lowly servants of the poor, just as Jesus was. We do what we can, leave undone what we can't. Yes, Jesus cares for our very basic needs, our health, our food, our emotions. But unlike us, he doesn't just care, he has the power to make us better, to show us the right way. He is humble and he wants to serve us. St. Teresa of Avila, the great 16th century Spanish saint, who is probably the greatest teacher of prayer in the history of the church, recommends that when you pray, or if you don't know how to pray, if you're at home, she says, draw up a chair opposite you and picture Jesus sitting in it and talk to him. And she says something very interesting. She says, picture Jesus looking at you lovingly and humbly. Lovingly and humbly. He's looking at you as if to say, not just I love you, which we believe that he does, but saying, how can I help you? How can I serve you? What do you want of me? What are you asking of me? He knows that our true food and our true healing is himself. As that first reading said, why do we spend our money on things that don't satisfy? We chase after so many pleasures in life. But really, if we find Jesus, if we know him, if we have a loving relationship with him, then we have everything. So his deepest desire is that we come to him, that we ask him to give us what we need, because he is full of riches. He can give us whatever he knows is best for us. He calls us to himself. He calls us through our joys, but he also calls us through our sorrows.
has spoken to the prophets.
I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church.
I confess all baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. Amen.
With trust in our Heavenly Father and the riches of His grace, we make our petitions known to Him. We pray that fervent devotion to the Eucharist will cause the Church to grow in numbers and in holiness. Lord, in your mercy,
Amen.
We pray for our legislators and government leaders, that they may pursue justice, truth, and peace. Lord, in your mercy,
Amen.
We pray for all those who work and live from the sea, among them sailors, fishermen, and their families. Lord, in your mercy,
Amen.
We pray for those who are at this moment bearing heavy burdens, that the Lord will build up strength within them and assist them in their need. Lord, in your mercy,
Amen.
We pray for our parish community that we may advance in faith, hope, and love. Lord, in your mercy,
Amen.
We ask Our Lady to help us to live with greater confidence in Christ's love. Hail Mary,
full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Loving Father, help us to put away our old selves and to be renewed in spirit, recreated in righteousness and holiness and truth, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Jesus and for the glory of his name. Our good and the good of all his holy church. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Thank you. Sunday we celebrate Mass at 12 noon every day. We continue to record the Mass. We also currently have a 1:30 p.m. Mass Monday to Friday. And while Father Jose Antonio is here, we also have a Mass in Spanish on Sundays at 1 p.m. Our church is open for prayer from 7 a.m. till 7 p.m. and the Blessed Sacrament exposed for most of that time. And we can hear confessions before Mass, after Mass, or by appointment. If you want to give to the support of the parish, please use the baskets at the back of the church. Plan giving envelopes are also available. We, of course, want everyone to feel safe in the church, so please do follow the instructions of the stewards when you come in to church. I can see plenty of empty spaces. We have quite a lot of space in the church, including seats over here, so there's no need for anyone to feel unsafe. I was talking to a doctor yesterday who assured me that you're about as safe as you can be in